Hi, this is Stelios from the TESSERACT Academy, and in this video, we're going to be talking about the differences between optimization and predictive analytics. Data science is an umbrella term that encapsulates many other disciplines. Primarily, it encapsulates statistics, machine learning, and AI. And I would also say that optimization is a very important part of data science. Unfortunately, these terms tend to be confused quite often, especially by people who are not data scientists, who do not work in this field. A problem I've also seen taking place quite often is non-technical people and decision makers confusing optimization with predictive analytics. While these two often go hand in hand, they're different things. And in this video, I'm going to be talking about what are the differences between these two fields of applications and how you can combine them and how you can use them and under what circumstances. Before we go there, let's talk briefly about the differences between statistics, machine learning, and optimization, just to make sure that we're all on the same page. So statistics as a discipline really shines when you care about transparency, okay? When you care about the why and the how. So if you care about things such as this variable X affects some other variable Y, or are there real differences between two groups, or what does the direction of an effect look like? This sounds a lot like a statistical problem. Machine learning, on the other hand, is better when you care about predictive power. So if you don't really care about the why or the how, but all you want to do is predict things into the future or classify objects, etc., then machine learning can provide you with some very, very powerful algorithms, which work like black boxes, but I mean, these are trade-offs, right? You basically sacrifice transparency for improved power and prediction. Also, machine learning is very good in dealing with complicated problems, such as computer vision and audio, like problems where you have lots and lots of data, lots and lots of variables. Optimization, on the other hand, is a field that deals with the question of how you can find the right settings, how you can find the right values for some parameters of a model or a system in order to maximize or minimize a goal. So let's see some examples of predictive analytics applications in order to understand the differences a bit better. So in predictive analytics, we're going to deal with questions such as, what will the demand for my product be next month, okay, or next week, or whatever, some point in the future? How can I predict the traffic based on parameters such as the day or the month, etc.? How busy will our hospital be based on parameters such as the day and the month and all this stuff, but also parameters such as the doctors, the number of nurses, that all of this could affect, for example, the waiting time in a hospital. Another question coming from IT would be around server load based on the number of users and usage patterns, etc. So optimization, on the other hand, does not deal with understanding the relationship, the direct relationship between the number of doctors and nurses and day and how busy a hospital will be. It doesn't care about this. Optimization algorithms care about finding the optimal values of the parameters of the things you can change in order to maximize or minimize an objective. So coming back to the traffic lights example, let's say they have a predictive model of the traffic in an urban environment. An optimization algorithm could help you understand how to best place the traffic lights in order to optimize the flow, right? So an optimization model could help you allocate the right number of ambulances and doctors across the week in order to minimize waiting times. This already assumes that you have a predictive model or at least a statistical model of some sort into which you can input some parameters which are directly in the real world under your control. You can control the total number of doctors that will be in a hospital or the number of ambulances. You know, you can buy more, for example. And then the algorithm tries to find the best solution for you. So these two are quite often confused, primarily because many times what people are interested in is the latter. They're interested in optimizing a goal. And they don't understand that in order to do that, they need to go through the first step. They need to build a proper model of that system, either statistical or more often a predictive model. So in reality, it's two steps, right? You have to build a predictive model first, and then you have to find the right values for the parameters, for the variables, in order to minimize or maximize your target variable, which could be cost, time, waiting times, whatever.